Good afternoon. The first item of business is time for reflection, and our time for reflection leader today is Father Gerard Hatton of St Patrick's Church, the Cowgate.
Good afternoon. My house shall be called a house of prayer. These words are from the prophet Isaiah that Jesus Christ referred to during the cleansing of the temple. It's not so much the fact that the animals were being sold and money exchanged in the temple that bothered him, as these were needed for ritual offerings. It is the exploitation of God's people, the fact that the devout were being overcharged and injustice reigned. The temple had become a den of thieves. The temple in Jerusalem was constructed to be a place of encountering God in prayer, built to be the dwelling place of God on earth. My house shall be called a house of prayer is also the motto of our oratorian community, to whom Archbishop Leo has entrusted St. Patrick's Church in the Cowgate. This church is your nearest Catholic church to the Parliament, and it soon will celebrate a 250 years jubilee on the 9th of October, marking the unique history of the place that was once a house of worship to Episcopalians, Presbyterians, and then to Catholics. It is a fitting home for Father Ninian and myself, with the motto, as it is intended, a house of prayer for the people of Edinburgh today and its many visitors from all over the world. It is a house that sings praises to God. It is a place of learning and discovering the Holy Scriptures, a place of meeting God. It is a house for the lonely and the confused, for a person of much faith or little. It's a refuge for sinners, as so many people come to the sacramental confession. It's also a house of joy as they leave it free, enriched by the beauty of the liturgy and ready with the gift of grace to brave the day. The church on the Cowgate is not a political movement nor a pressure group. St. Patrick stands to give God glory and to be a gate for all to witness a little bit of heaven here in Edinburgh. St. Patrick is dedicated to prayer and transformation that will come. We see this in our parishioners. We see this in our homeless friends, in the works of charity, and the people from near and far who have a connection with St. Patrick's. I hope that you have a place that is holy to you, where you can be yourself. I know that my St. Patrick's helps me to be and provokes in me to be more. Have a good afternoon.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you.